Nexus and Forrest Grillo, and the subject is Scott Hall's addiction issues. Hey team, sending in my first ever email to you guys to say about how much I love that Vader interview. I was expecting the usual trash, like the Jericho one, only kidding guys, but that Vader one was so cool. He went so raw, and Conan's speech about guys in your industry dealing with addiction problems really hit home, as me and my three brothers have all dealt with addiction issues during our lives. 5 years sober for me.
Congrats.
Yeah, congrats.
Regarding addictions in wrestling, I would like to ask you guys a question about Scott Hall. From what I've learned over the years, Hall was just a party guy his whole career before like 97 and 98. It went from someone getting messed up at the party to being straight up addicted to booze and drugs. Conan and Disco, do you just remember seeing Hall change, or you notice, are you noticing that he was being hooked? What was the mood like backstage around him? And a follow-up, as Nash becoming top babyface in 98 and Booker in WCW, do you know if he ever fell out with other drifted apart from Scott Hall? I know they're cool now, and the NWO and reunion angle 99, but I was just wondering if Hall's problems put a strain on their relationship. This guy's a hammer, is that man? That good. Hall was, let me tell you about Scott Hall. Very brilliant guy, but it's just very weird. Like, remember, you know how like Xanax is like a drug of choice for a lot of people, right?
Yeah, I mean, yeah.
Hall could take like 20 Xanax in a day, and it would have like the op, like the because he was like maybe bipolar. I don't know what it was.
Yeah,
but it would have the opposite effect that he could like literally like take like 20 Xanax a day.
Yeah,
other people would take one Xanax and you're out for like 12 hours.
Out,
you're like, yeah. But he would like, it was just like a verse, and like Raven was like that too.
It's like
there's so many guys in our business that took so many depressants, painkillers that they just
made,
like
it gave them energy. It gave them energy instead of slowing them down.
Kurt Angle talks about it.
Yeah,
you know, like these things, like they like these guys had issues with pills, but they managed to perform. Very weird, you know. It's like it's just fascinating to think, like, you know, like guys like get high, drunk, pill, but you know. And still go out on TV and, like, you know, like perform content that's recorded and we can like view it and say like, wow, that's like tremendous. Was this guy messed up when he was on it? It's like, maybe. Yeah. You know,
because Nash would say that before him and Michaels went out to the ring for like a main event on a house show, they would time it. So, all right, we're gonna do a 20-minute match.
They take their somas beforehand.
Yeah, like 10 minutes before, and then as soon as they started feeling it,
they take it before they go out.
Yeah.
The match would be 15 minutes long. They come back and drink beers, and like, it would be the perfect buzz.
Yeah.
I've done that too. Like, bro, these are things that, like, the wrestlers, like, bro, this is the weird part of our business, is that we're masochists. I mean, if you can't comprehend the physical, you know, stress on your body, even in its simplicity, that wrestling does to you.
Yeah.
You know, you could be a basic worker and just tackle, drop down, headlock, take 4 or 5 bumps a match, and then you tell somebody, like, you try to like talk to somebody that's never experienced anything like that before, and you say, okay, well, just do this: go in your living room where there's a carpet,
just fall,
and just fall down on your back, you know, and try that one time and see how that feels. And it's like, we do that, like, you know, over the course of a year, thousands of times.
Yeah.
On a surface, it's roughly like, maybe it doesn't feel like that hard, but 70% of that, you know, and you just wonder, like, okay, well, how do these people deal with these physical, with the aches and pains? And like, I've always told people that, like, in my life, I don't feel comfortable unless I'm aching or taking somebody to relieve my aches.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if I feel completely fine, I'm like, that feels weird to me.
Yeah.
Because I still work out. I still work out hard. Still, you know, and I'm like, I get body, but, you know, just parts of my body just feel, you know, they ache. And if I don't have that, it's like I don't feel like I don't know. I just don't feel like it's real life.
It's not a normal day. Yeah.
Very, very. And that's a weird mindset that I've developed. You know, I don't know how many other people in the business feel like that, but it's like it's weird. Like, you don't, unless you're, if your body feels completely comfortable, I don't know if that exists in people in this business. And I just wonder if people like that wonder what we do for a living. It's like, okay, do you feel comfortable in your body every day?
No.
It's like, oh yeah, I feel good. It's like, well, we don't feel anything like that.
I mean, look at Hulk. people don't consider Hulk like a bump machine, but from dropping the leg for all those years, how many surgeries did he have to have on his back?
I mean, that stimulator. Randy Savage,
yeah.
Randy Savage doing the top rope elbow drop, landing on your hip of the Conan. Like you, how do you feel about that?
What's the question? Because you kind of rambled.
Like, do you feel? I know I rambled, but do you feel like the same way that like if you don't, do you feel comfortable? Like, do you ever feel like you have no aches?
Never, ever.
Never.
Yeah.
But you feel comfortable.
Yeah.
Even in
I've learned to live with the pain.
Right. It's a very weird, like we're very closet masochists.
And the weird thing is I learned to live without pills, where before I always used to, bro. And it's funny because when you're talking about Scott, when, you know, this guy's talking about how much of a partier Scott Hall was.
He was a pill head.
He was a partier. And Scott told me that when he broke into the business, he was didn't drink, he didn't do no drugs, nothing. You know, Alberto Del Rio told me the same thing.
Right.
The first 10 years that I was in the business, I did zero drugs. You know what I'm saying? Then when I got to WCW, the pills, you know? And it's almost like it's almost like guys that have never done pills and shit like that, and then when they finally do it, they just go overboard. You know what I'm saying?
Let me throw this out there. You know the WWE is cracked down years ago on pills, right?
What?
They cracked down years ago on pills.
Right.
Did you know? I don't know if you know this, but maybe you do. But they like, you know, somas are a banned substance there now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You knew that, right?
They did that.
Bro,
I know that because I used to sell them.
Right.
They did that after there was it was Matt Hardy that had a problem on a flight or something.
A lot of guys had problems.
Yeah.
Right. But a lot of guys didn't have problems with them. Right. Because like I was always a two beer, two somas guy. You know, maybe after my match, it relaxed. It made me feel better. You know, and that's what my combination of drugs and pills, whatever it was, like, but like, you know, you can't comprehend unless you've tried this before the level of pain or aching and stuff. And that what we do for a living, it's like if you're trying to like regulate how we make ourselves feel better without any previous knowledge of like what we do or previous experience of what we do, it's a very weird conversation.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because WWE decided to like, you know, okay, we're going to get people stopped hooked on the pills. So what's happened now? Okay, I'll tell you what's happened now. And as a perfect example is I met like when it was a Hard Rock Hotel, but it's now the Virgin Hotel, right? And years and years and years ago, not many years ago, but there was a considerable amount of years ago, the WWE was in town, and Christian was working for the WWE. And it was a night that he worked with Randy Orton, and he got lit up in the ring, and he got a concussion, right? And I had previously talked to him during the night, you know, but beforehand, like not during the night, beforehand, hey, let's meet up at the bar afterwards, and let's get a drink. Because I'd known him from Impact, and like we'd become friends, right? So I went, and like, like some of the boys were there, and some of the Vicky Guerrero was there. I said hi to her or something, but he was like messed up, right? Because he could tell. Like it was funny because like it was a night he got a concussion. Like because he was saying I got fucked up in there tonight, and we were talking. But all these guys did was drink, right? Because they can't take pills anymore. All right, and when like I don't know what, you know, it's a weird thing to like try to like navigate your way through like what we do for a living. Because there's no other people on this planet Earth besides, you know, than professional wrestlers that put their body through physical stress where like you're taking bumps and like your back and like stuff in there is undergoing stress where like your back is hitting the surface like repeatedly, right? So we're completely outside the box on, you know, okay, how do we deal with people that want to, you know, deal with this type of like pain management, right? And so it's like if you take away like the pills and stuff and the muscle, you know, stuff, and he's like, dude, everybody's gonna just double down on the
drinking,
alcohol.
Yeah.
And that's what we're seeing.
Yeah.
I've seen like, bro, everybody in this business. We had Jericho on the show. Now it's weed and drinking.
Yeah.
It used to be pills.
Yeah.
But it's like it's weed and drinking, but the drinking is getting a little excessive,
mm-hmm.
You know, because people are, you look at what they're doing on the show, it's like, I'm like, I can imagine like a guy like Darby Allin or these, you know, other people that do these things, like their bodies, like, what are they doing? You know, and it's like, I mean, this is an issue. Nobody likes to talk about it, you know, but like it's there. You know, I mean, Conan, what do you think?
What's the question?
Do you think that like maybe like because like there's a negativity towards
pills,
you know, for pain management, that it's kind of like okay that everybody's graduated towards like alcohol and then weed to like manage the pain.
Heavy drinking. But Conan, you use weed to manage your pain, and that's better than taking a bunch of pills.
Opioids.
Yeah, it's better, much better.
I just think it's ridiculous how many people are smoking weed now. It's like the majority, you know?
Well, it's kind of, because it's generally like, it's enough of states have like, say, okay, enough of people, it's like gambling. You know, more
but you got to remember, Disco, we've been in the business for over 30 years and been in a lot of dress rooms, and we've always been the type of guys that hang out after the show, right? And we know who does what. Right. Nobody was doing weed 30 years ago, 20 years ago, right. 10 years ago. You know what I'm saying? So now for me to see that, it's like cool because I was talking with this with some of the young guys. It's better than being on cocaine or meth or Nubane or GHB. All those were ugly drugs. You know what I'm saying? So if you're going to be on something, this is cool to be on. And, you know, and the liquor is not as I think there's more people drinking. There's more people smoking weed than actual liquor.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's a real generational thing, and I really believe. And I've talked to the young guys about this, and this is what they tell me. You know, we saw what you guys did to yourselves, your generation, and we don't want to end up like that. Yeah. You know,
well, Hall and Nash have said that the reason
why do they want to end up like that?
Well, look how many guys died of drug overdoses or became drug addicts.
Right.
I think that was more for the steroids.
Well,
no, bro. How many guys didn't have drug overdoses and were
addicted
to drugs or had to go to rehab or didn't show up on time or, you know, come on.
A lot of the deaths, there was opioids in their system now in Somas.
Here's what I'm saying. I honestly think that, like, the steroids on top of everything else was is a mitigating factor.
It's a terrible
cocktail. Because here's the thing. You know, you look at all the guys that died, right? All the guys that died back in the day, they were like, you know, that did drugs and stuff. They were all doing steroids. There's not a lot of steroids in the business these days, so there's not a lot of people dying. But
you don't see a lot of bodybuilders dying from steroids, or baseball players, or football players, and they're all on it. It was our parting over the top rock star lifestyle, bro. Yeah, the steroids. How much it added? I don't know. But bro, doing pills and coke and meth and all the they were doing
drinking
back then, and you saw it, bro. You were seeing you saw what I saw.
I go 100% agree, but I think that like the guys that did all that with the steroids,
yeah, maybe it compounded your death. What I'm saying is, why aren't we seeing that in football, in baseball, in basketball? You're not seeing a lot of
early
death.
Like wrestling,
I don't think that the combination is there anymore.
Mm.
It's like there's nothing the guy.
But even back then. But even back then, in the 90s, Barry Bonds and Sammy Sosa and all those were all taking steroids.
But they weren't doing coke and stuff. I'm talking about the people that died because everybody thought were drug overdoses.
Yeah.
But the drug overdoses, the deaths were combined with the steroids, which like
cocaine could be.
Packed. Yeah. Yes.
I'm not sure. Yeah.
That's the same.